great to be here. Thank you guys for hanging out. song's called Memoir.
Bye. choose rather this. Thank you.
earth. The blood of his mother is mixed with the earth. She's just a child, is dropping in pain from the terror of birth by the light of a king. Now they lay that small baby where creatures come eat like a meal for the swine who have no clue that he is still holding together the world that they see. They don't know just how long he has to go.
Yeah!
Please, guys, support things like this. Find ways to tell them you care. Things like this, sometimes they seem like we take them for granted and then they don't exist anymore. And I think everybody gets the gist of what I'm saying. Let's not let that happen again, all right? You guys agree? There's not a lot of places to do this kind of thing, so we're super, super gracious. Also forgot to give a shout out. Our good friend Dan drove 12 hours with us. He's probably around here somewhere. But my friend Dan's about to get married. And if you've ever played in Johnstown, you know Dan. But he's a good dude and I love him and I'm proud to call him my friend and I'm happy for him. We're gonna play one more, but there's been this narrative in my life that I kind of always thought I was gonna arrive at some point. And I thought first, you know, it'd be like when I went to school or something. And then I thought like, you know, when I finish college or when I get married, maybe when I have a kid, which I haven't done yet. But what I'm discovering as I get older, and I'm 34 this year, is that everyone is still waiting to arrive and no one's there. When you meet someone really cool or wise, if you get them to sit down and be honest, they'll tell you some things have gone really well and they may have figured some things out, but it's never all just magically fallen together, or at least not for long. And that rings true in the most important relationship I have in my life. And I don't know what that is for you, but the most important relationship in my life is actually not the one with my wife. That's the second one. It's the one with my Creator. And that's been a journey that I've been on my whole life. And I don't know your background. I don't know what you believe. But I just from one artist to a person who appreciates art, it's important for us, for you to know where this comes from. We love doing this. Like, don't get me wrong. It's amazing to get in the car with my buds and drive and come play a show and hang out. But at some point, it gets old. It's hard to believe, but everything can get old. And the thing that motivates us to keep making art, and the reasons I can't stop writing music, and the reason I can't stop trying to express myself that way is one, it's one of the ways that I process things. I actually don't write songs to explain. I write songs to understand. I'm trying to figure it out. But the one thing I can say, even though I'm a Christian and I love God, and maybe that's you, maybe that's not you, maybe you don't know where you're at. But I'd say there's been this journey that I've been on, and there's been so many times when I'm not quite sure what's going on, and something that I thought was so foundational has been torn away, and I haven't known what to do. And I just want to say, I know for a fact that that's where a lot of you up in this room are, that you're struggling and you're trying to figure it out, because it's what we all want to do. We want to figure it out. We want to move forward. If there's a God, if there's a something, if there's a modus operandi, we want to know what it is. And maybe you're somewhere on that journey, maybe you've walked away, whatever, but I just want to say I would have quit believing in God a long time ago if it was a system that I believed in, if it was a subscription, if it was a loyalty, if it was an oath, if it was a vow, I would have broken it. But thankfully, it's none of those things. It's proven to be a relationship. And I'm figuring out, even at this age, even after seminary and all this stuff, I'm still trying to figure out what to do with the Bible. I'm still trying to figure out what to do with the church. Because I don't know if you're like me, but I read the Bible and I go to churches and I go, man, this doesn't look a lot like what I'm reading. And I meet a lot of people who call themselves Christians and they don't seem very gracious or very loving. And don't get me wrong, I don't want to be defined by the things that I don't like, but there's a lot of confusion in my heart at times. And I'm not sure what to make of it. But there's this subtle thing, which is that there's just this tug in my heart. And, you know, I went over to hear Derek Webb for one song, and I don't know if you missed that, you really missed out, but he played one of my favorite songs I've ever heard in my life, and he's written better lyrics than I'll ever write in my life, but he has a lyric when he says, I'm a whore, I do confess, but I'll put you on like a wedding dress, and I'll run down the aisle. And just take it from one guy, and this is kind of where we're all at. Like, I don't have it all figured out, and I probably am sure of less things than I used to be, but I'm more sure that God is real. And I'm more sure in my life that there's this, that God is trying to communicate to us. And that's a very confusing process. And every religion claims to have figured out how he's communicating, what he has to say, what his agenda is. But I just want to say this to you from us. I think Jesus is a blinding moment of clarity because God steps into his creation. And don't get me wrong, I believe that Jesus is God. That's what I believe. And I can argue with you to some point, but I will admit it's faith. If it was a list of facts, it wouldn't be called faith. At some point, there's something that happened in my heart that I can't describe. But Jesus is God. But what's helped me more recently is understanding it's hard to relate to him. How do I relate to a God that's out there? Jesus is also like God. What I mean is, like, yes, Jesus is God, but if you're like, I don't know how to relate to God, he's so far off and he's so distant, and I don't know what to do with him, he would look like Jesus if he was walking by. He would want to talk to you. He would want to be gracious if you needed mercy. If you were full of pride, he would want to tell you so. He would want to share a meal with you. He would want to be gracious. And I don't know where you're all at in this room, and I respect your whole journey. Don't believe something because a dude in a band told you. I'm probably not the wisest dude in the room even. I'm just sharing honestly. If it means something to you, I think God's after your heart. And more than ever, the fact that God loves you and that he sent his only son for you blows my mind. And I just want to say it so simply, but I think God loves you. And I think he stepped into this planet, and I just encourage you to look at Jesus. And through all this struggle and journey in my life, it's not like been like a total identity crisis, but God has proven to be more faithful and more good than ever. And I wrote a song about that journey because it was real to me, and it's real to a lot of people in my life, and I pray that it encourages you. And as long as you look at what you believe about God as a list of facts or religion, it's going to fall apart at some point. It'll never succeed. But if it becomes something more than that, and if God is speaking, and if you take the time to listen, I think something amazing will happen. So thank you for listening. We appreciate you. We'll be here hanging out tonight. It's been a privilege to be here.
From the start, I try to scare.
Grace and peace from my epic. Thank you for listening.